The Wing Chun dummy, called the Moth Yong Jong, is patterned after the human body. The two upper arms represent the arms of a person at chest level. The small distance between the two arms is to limit the elbow position so that you have to keep the elbow close to your body. The middle arm represents the arm or leg at waist level, and the lower leg represents the knee or lower leg. Techniques in the form can be broken down into practical combinations, which can be applied against a real opponent. Here Master Fong demonstrates Sip Ma Tanda from the dummy form. These motions should also be practiced in the air without a partner. The purpose of the Sip Ma Tanda is to avoid meeting a very strong incoming force head-on, while at the same time blocking and attacking. Notice how Master Fong moves his stance to neutralize his opponent's kick. The block and attack are simultaneous, which destroys the opponent's structure. In Wing Chun, a major principle is to rotate the blocking and attacking hands in a continual flow. Here Master Fong demonstrates rotation of his attacking and blocking hands with Noi Quan Sao and Jet Da. Noi Quan Sao uses a circling motion to move the attacking line. The Jet Da pulls the opponent into the strike. In application, you may have to adjust to an opponent's attacking position, so the techniques may not be exactly as they are on the dummy. Here Master Fong circles with Noi Quan Sao as he strikes with a chop to the neck. He rotates his hands by controlling with Pak Sao and hits with a low palm strike to the opponent's side. Another principle in Wing Chun is to use opposite forces to increase power and to break the opponent's structure. The more power the opponent uses, the more you can use that power against him. Here Master Fong demonstrates two techniques that use opposite forces. The first technique is called Lop Chong Gang, which is a palm pull and a high chop. The second technique is called Jut Chong Jong, which is a snap and control with another high chop. In application, the more forward force the opponent uses, the more pulling or snapping force you will have. Consequently, your attacking techniques will have extra power from the added momentum. Here Master Fong demonstrates these principles against an opponent's attack. In Wing Chun, a block can be used to attack, or an attack can be used to block. In Ganjam, you can use Gan Sao motion to attack and Jam to block, or you can use Gan to block and Jam Sao to attack. The application of these techniques depends on the opponent's structure. Different heights and angles of attack will require different blocks. Wing Chun is not a rigid style, so you're not locked into a set pattern. You control the technique should not control you. Here Master Fong adjusts to the height of his opponent's punch with a Hyun Sao, which uses the same principle as Gan Sao. He strikes at the same time with a chop, which uses the same principle as jamsao. He then follows up with a pull-by attack to destroy his opponent's structure. In Wing Chun, mobility is essential, both to avoid confrontation with a strong force and to change the line to create openings. In addition, mobility in stances is necessary for adjusting the distance for kicks. Master Fong's step slide changes the line between himself and the attack, allowing an opening for the Fun Sao motion. He then adjusts to open space for a front kick. As his opponent executes a strong driving punch, Master Fong adjusts his stance to the side to avoid meeting the force head-on and to create an opening for his Fun Sao attack. He adjusts again to execute Jingirk to his opponent's midsection. In Wing Chun, the opponent's force should be deflected instead of meeting it head-on. When practicing on the dummy, you should adjust your stance by turning or moving so that your blocking motion deflects the arm, which is in reality the attack. Because a dummy does not move, you have to move to do this. Master Fong turns with a tonsao to deflect the attack. At the same time, he punches on the center line. He then rotates his hands, executing jutsao to make control of the opponent and the center line while punching with the other arm. Here Master Fong demonstrates tanda jeta against an opponent. Notice how Master Fong's arms work together in each technique. His control and attack work simultaneously. In Wing Chun, the hands assist the legs, and the legs assist the hands. The hands may control the legs into a kick, or the kick may set up a situation for a hand attack. Master Fong controls the attacking line with Hyun Sao while executing Dai Jing Girk to the knee. Wing Chun kicks are called invisible kicks. This is because most of the time when you kick, the opponent is busy with your hands, so cannot see or feel the kick coming. In Wing Chun, you can also use one hand both to block and attack. This must be done by first destroying the opponent's structure before attacking. Cao Sao pulls the opponent's attack forward and off the line, creating an opening for a chop. Chun Gang changes into a snapping motion to control the line as the punch is executed. Master Fong uses Cao Sao to pull the opponent into the chop and in a continuous motion pulls the chopping hand back to control with Jet as he punches on the center line. Biu Sao means shooting fingers. This name explains the way that the motion is done, shooting out. Biu Sao does not mean to use the fingertips to strike. Instead, the arm shoots out, contacting with the side of the hand or forearm in either a block or an attack. Jet Sao pulls the attack off the line to set up a Biu Sao strike. Timing is important in a technique such as this because the opponent may regain his position. The Biu Sao strike must immediately follow the Jet Sao snap to capitalize on the opening of the line. Master Fong turns to snap the opponent forward with jet sao and into his Busao strike. Notice how Busao slides over the opponent's arm, controlling the center line position with the elbow down. In order to generate power in a short distance, you have to use drilling power. Jong Lo Kyun is a punch that utilizes this type of drilling power. The punch drills forward and not upward. It is not an uppercut. This power can also be applied in chops. Hyun Sao opens the center line for the first drilling technique, and Pak Sao controls the opponent's position for the second technique. As the opponent punches, Master Fong turns and deflects the attack with Hyun Sao as he strikes with Jong Lo Kyun. He quickly follows up, turning with the Pak Sao control and another drilling punch. Notice how the elbow drills the punch forward. Wing Chun also utilizes upward deflecting techniques to open up the center line position for an attack. These techniques are often used in conjunction with a low kick, because the kicking line is open. Control and the kick should be timed together to make the maximum use of the break in the opponent's structure. A second kick may follow the first, but it should be a different kick or in a different line from the first kick to have the most power. Double pow sao moves the opponent's attack upward to open up the center line and create an opening for the low front kick. As Master Fong turns, he executes a low sidekick using Bong Sao to protect the upper gate. Master Fong comes underneath his opponent's attack with double pow sao to open the center line while he executes a Dai Jing Girk to the forward knee. Quickly capitalizing on his opponent's failing posture, he executes a Dai Wang Girk to the same knee, protecting himself with Bong Sao. Wing Chun is known as a close fighting system. Knee attacks lend themselves well to infighting because they are shorter range than many kicks. The hands assist the knee attack by controlling the opponent into the knee strike. Master Fong deflects the attack with Tan Sao, at the same time punching on the center line. He changes both hands into an arm control to pull the opponent into his knee. As his opponent steps in with a punch, Master Fong deflects the attack and simultaneously punches. A Wing Chun practitioner should be able to flow from one attack to the next, blocking each attack in a way that opens up the inside line for his own attack. To do this, the practitioner must have a flexible stance, and he must also be able to change from attack to defense quickly. Master Fong uses a step slide to adjust his line in order to block with Hyun Sao and chop with Dai Jong. He then rolls out with Noi Kwan Sao to deflect the second attack and finishes with a butterfly palm strike. As his opponent steps in with a punch, Master Fong simultaneously blocks and attacks. When his opponent attacks with a second punch, Master Fong rolls to destroy the attacking line and finishes with a pull-by strike on the inside line. In Wing Chun, the use of the legs depends on the situation. Sometimes hand techniques flow better, and so the legs are utilized in stances. At other times, leg blocks and leg attacks flow from a particular situation. Sticky legs practice develops the ability to feel the opening and timing to use the legs. In all cases, the hand should assist the legs. Master Fong blocks with both Tan Sao and his knee, then he controls with Lop Sao to attack the opponent's leg with Jet Girk and finishes with a raising knee to the midsection. As the opponent attacks with double punches, Master Fong blocks with Tan Sao and Wu Sut. He immediately changes into a lop control and snaps Jet Girk to destroy his opponent's leg structure. Master Fong controls the opponent and braces his technique on the opponent's shoulder to snap Tai Suit into the opponent's midsection. The Wing Chun dummy is a major training device for the Wing Chun system. Although other systems of Kung Fu have dummies, they do not have the same design. Each type of dummy has its own purpose and theory behind it. So for each system of Kung Fu, there may be differences in how a dummy is built. In order to practice Wing Chun, you must use the correct dummy that was created many years ago for this style. The Monk Jong is an invaluable training aid for a number of reasons. The dummy develops Wing Chun stances and the ability to use stances with techniques. To execute the dummy form properly, you must learn to move your stances the correct distance from the dummy. Being too close to the dummy will jam your own structure, and being too far away will make you lose power and effectiveness. The correct distance produces the best angle for blocks and attacks. You must find the right distance to move around the dummy. Not everyone will adjust in the same distance. Taller people will adjust differently than smaller people. This feeling for the right distance is essential for developing the correct Wing Chun structure in relation to an opponent. It is also crucial for chasing and knowing the necessary distance to execute techniques. The correct movement around the dummy is a semicircle moving no more than 45 degrees to each side of the dummy center. Moving this pattern teaches you that if you move too far from the dummy, you will lose contact and create a gap. In reality, a gap would mean that an opponent has more distance and time to strike and block. To prevent this type of opening, you need to try to keep the same radius around the Monk Jong so that you will stick to an opponent's hands in a fight. There is a saying which applies to the idea of keeping a proper distance in fighting. This saying goes, as long as you have your foot in the door, keep it there. Since the dummy is immovable, it forces you to adjust to its structure. This teaches you how to adjust to an opponent's structure in a real-life situation. In each technique in the dummy, you must adjust so that your attack is on the attacking center line between you and the dummy. As you move in a semicircle around the dummy, you must adjust your own position to develop the correct line for each motion. In a fight, the attacking and blocking lines between you and opponent will constantly change. The Monk Jong helps you develop the perfect structure and line so you can apply the Wing Chun centerline theory against an opponent. Working on the Monk Jong helps you develop better body unity. Body unity in Wing Chun is the ability to maintain the correct Wing Chun structure in all techniques. Turning or moving is one unit, with the stance bracing every technique. When practicing on the Monk Jong, you should pay special attention to your stance and body unity, because body unity produces more power and a stronger structure. Many Wing Chun techniques will not work effectively without body unity, so it is essential to develop the skill of moving as one unit. Monk Jong form is divided into two major sections. The first 60 motions make up the first section, which is based on applications of techniques from the Sulam Tao and the Chum Kyu forms. These techniques are combined to teach you how hands and legs flow together in Wing Chun. The principles of blocking and attacking simultaneously, alternating hands, and the centerline theory are incorporated into the motions. Each technique should be completed and the power released on contact with the dummy before the next motion is begun. This will develop the correct release of power for the motion. Moving around the dummy with the correct stance and completing the motions at the same time the stance stops will develop body unity. By using natural power and not strength when striking the dummy, and by releasing power at the correct time, you develop stronger forearms, hands, and legs through bone packing. All of these skills developed on the Monk Jong will build a better Wing Chun foundation. The second half of the dummy form is based on applications of emergency techniques from the Buji form. It also develops more Wing Chun hand and leg combinations. Buji emergency techniques are designed to recover or regain the line when you have lost it during a close fighting situation. In the second half of the dummy, there are many combinations of techniques to regain lost position, utilizing both hands and legs. There are also ginger fist and phoenix eye punches, which are considered more advanced because they require more body unity and coordination to be effective. The very last set of the dummy combines a series of leg attacks and blocks coordinated with hand controls to develop leg flow. All these techniques can be applied in emergency situations. Practicing the Monk Jong will improve your overall ability in Wing Chun and develop many valuable skills for fighting. There are a number of principles to follow when practicing the Monk Yon Jong. Use tapping to build up your power gradually. Do not hit hard. You should not get bruises if you practice on a dummy correctly. Move in a semicircle around the dummy. Do not go past 45 degrees from the center on either side. Keep the same distance when moving around the Monk Jong. stick with the dummy whenever possible. Some motions you must come off the dummy's arms, but stick as much as you can to develop sticking power. Always direct the power in your technique toward the center of the dummy. The power should go in on the attacking and blocking center lines. The eyes should look at the Monk Jong at head level. This develops steady eye power. Adjust your movements according to the dummy. Not all dummies have the same dimensions, and sometimes taller people will place a dummy higher than normal. You must adjust to the height of the dummy. Use body unity while moving. Time your technique so that the stance and hand or leg motions finish at the same time. Do not lose the proper Wing Chun stance while moving. Learn how to execute centerline attacks and blocks. Pay attention to all techniques so that each one is on the center line. Maintain the correct distance for your techniques while moving around the dummy. You should not have to reach for the dummy, and you should not be jammed up. Adjust each movement to get the correct distance. Following these principles will improve your Monk Jong practice and your skill in Wing Chun. Developing power is a major focus of practicing on the dummy. The correct application of power is to use tapping motions that release power at the correct time. Tapping develops stronger bones because the energy of the strike is packed into the bone marrow. With a great deal of practice, the bone becomes more solid since bone grows in response to stress. Tapping the Monk Jong develops the iron bridge forearm. The more you practice, the stronger the bridge and your tapping will become. But never use force to hit the Monk Jong. The harder you try to hit the dummy, the less power you develop because you have to use muscular strength. In Wing Chun, power is not developed through muscle strength. It is developed through using only natural tension and techniques until contact. On contact, all the joints should snap and work together to produce a forward whipping or explosive power. This joint power is combined with the squeezing of the forearm and hand muscles to direct the power out. On contact, the muscles must be relaxed immediately to release the power forward. Wing Chun power is similar to the power released from a whip. The snapping of all the parts of a whip at the end of the motion produce more power than if each part of the whip is worked separately. If you can release power in this way, and you can control how power is released, your skill level is high. If you have to use strength to produce power, and you cannot control the power, you must practice to use less muscle strength and work on developing the ability to control your power. Your power will increase with the correct practice. Wing Chun has many exercises to develop sticking power. In a fight, you add your opponent's momentum to your own technique through sticking and controlling. Added momentum means added power. The Monk Jong develops sticking power through the practice of sticking to the dummy's arms whenever possible. During the form, analyze where it is proper to stick and where it is necessary to leave the arms. The more you practice correctly, the better your sticking power will become. The techniques in the dummy form come from the Wing Chun forms, but are applied as if in sticky hands. A major Wing Chun principle in sticky hands attacks is to rotate the hands to be able to produce the maximum power in your techniques and to control the opponent continuously. The Monk Jong form follows this principle with rotation of hand attacks and blocks in most techniques. There will always be certain situations in sticky hands practice where one hand will be used to block an attack. And so there are some techniques in the dummy form where one hand blocks and attacks. But in general, the most favorable fighting situation is where one hand controls and the other attacks, and the hands are rotated from each succeeding attack. The motion of the hands is in an up and down or back and forth rotation. This produces a continuous balanced flow of techniques. With a great deal of practice, your hands will flow more naturally in sticky hands, and the techniques from the dummy form will flow out without any thought on your part. Timing is an important aspect of training on the Monk Jong. When you practice the techniques in the air by yourself, you are practicing self-timing. When you practice timing on the dummy, you are practicing timing between two subjects. You must adjust your timing of the release of power to the moment when you contact the dummy. Since you are moving around the dummy, this timing may be different each time you execute a technique. You must develop feeling for the second you contact the dummy, then you release the power. The movement of the stance and body is involved in timing as well. The stance motion must end at the same time you contact the dummy. This is body unity, which is necessary for the most efficient production of power. The dummy develops many important skills for fighting. Practicing on the Monk Jong will improve your mobility, flow, timing, structure, and power. Master Fong has published a number of books on Wing Chun. If you are interested in more information on theories or forms, please call or write to Master Augustine Fong in Tucson for further information. Bye.